Room of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. I am Sri Kumar. The class is for 10th standard students. Subject is Mathematics. Let me begin the class.
Dear students, we are entering into the last part of the lesson where you will be learning about application of trigonometry. Like Pythagoras theorem and other theorems you have studied, trigonometry and its ratios are having good applications in our day-to-day life and in having good questions for the examinations too. And my dear student, you should take interest to understand how these trigonometric ratios are applied in different situations. One thing is quite clear. In the case of trigonometric ratios, a right angle triangle is what is deciding the concept of a ratio. So, our attempt must be in order to find out the hidden right angle in every situation. Okay, I will come to that point later. Let me revise what you learned about trigonometry before entering into its applications. And in that case, you remember this particular photograph. You should. This is the cover page of your mathematics textbook part 2. And this is the cover page of your mathematics textbook part 2 of 9th standard. These textbooks cover page is decided depending on or by taking into consideration the application of trigonometry. I mean, among the lessons you studied, something which is having beautiful applications in day-to-day life is trigonometry and trigonometric ratios. That may be the reason, I assume. Anyway, understand the importance and take interest. Let me just revise what you learned in 9th standard. You learned about the different ratios of sine, cos and tan with respect to the angles in a right angle to triangle. We named it as theta and the other angle was named as 90 minus theta and the third angle is the right angle. So there are three angles, right angle, theta angle and 90 minus theta. Theta is a denotion, just denoting a particular angle in Greek alphabet. This also you know from 9th standard. You also developed a new ratio of inverse of sine, cos and tan, like cosec, sec and cot respectively, and its relationship with its counterpart, like sine theta into cos theta is equal to 1, cos theta into cosec theta is equal to 1, tan theta and cot theta is equal to 1. All this relationship you studied well in 9th standard. If you don't remember, it will be difficult for you to follow further. So it is better go back to 9th standard and remember. You can go back to 9th standard video and see that also and recollect everything, as well as you know that when you learned about multiplication table in class 2 or 3, it was a very difficult job for you. It was very difficult to remember that table up to number 11 or 12. Later, nowadays in everyday life, we are using the table in while going to the shop, while in the train, while buying the ticket in bus or wherever you go. You use multiplication table very frequently. My dear friend, the same way, you should be thorough with the table of ratios of trigonometric values. For example, at least for 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, you should be thorough with. And for your easiness, I would like to say that this particular first three ratios, which are sine theta, cos theta and tan theta, you have studied and you have understood thoroughly in 9th standard. When we put the inverse of it, you get this ratio. The inverse is shown over here, 1 upon sine theta, 1 upon cos theta, 1 upon tan theta. That means this will be the inverse of 1 upon 2 here, which is equal to 2. So only thing what you have to study is the first three ratios by heart and later will follow automatically. And using this regularly and frequently will make you comfortable with it, just like what happened with your multiplication table. Understood. So this is my humble request that you should be very thorough, very thorough, very thorough with the values in this table. Most of the values are repeated. You can see 2 here, you can see 2 here. That means they are correlated. That means cosec 30 and sec 60 are same. There are relationship between tan and cot also. If you say, you can see, for example, 1 upon root 3 here, tan 30, the same value you can see in cot 60. So once you spend a little time with this table, you will be very thorough with in mind, but by using it regularly, you will become very expert in using it. Okay, let me go ahead. Something more you studied this year, it was about trigonometric identities. The identities that you should remember and by heart is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta, and 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. These three, how these three relationship derived is given in your textbook, and I have given it in the last video. That is part 1 of this lesson. You should go back and be very clear about it. This much of basic information is required before going ahead with the application of trigonometry. Along with that, certain terms you should be familiar with. One of the terms you should be familiar with is lines of vision. Line of vision is a concept where if you are looking from A to a object at B, you can draw a line connecting A and B. That line is called line of vision. For example, if you are looking at up in a particular direction, you are from here to here, here the object is, you can draw a line, that is what is called line of vision. It can be on the left side or right side, it can be down right, left or down right. And when we look up, we have a line of vision towards up, and we call such a line of vision as line of elevation with respect to this horizontal line. The horizontal line is a parallel line to our eyes. With respect to that, the line is going up or above. We call that angle, which is created here, as the angle of elevation. Elevator, you know that, which will be lifting you. So you will be lifting your head or eye to see the object. Then we call it as angle of elevation will be created with respect to the horizontal line drawn in with respect to your eyes. So these are angle of elevation. While looking down, we call it as angle created is named as angle of depression. Understood? Angle of depression. This is angle of depression, which I marked green over here. This is angle of depression. This is also angle of depression. So this you should be very thorough with. When we see above the horizontal line, the angle formed is called angle of elevation. When we see below the horizontal line, the angle formed is called the angle of depression. Many times we need to know the height of a tower or a building or the distance of a ship from the lighthouse. Many such situations comes in our day-to-day life and in the activities. Trigonometry help in this situation. I will show you the real situation, how trigonometry can be used in such a situation. Suppose that there is a tree of which height we wish to know, and we cannot climb on the tree and measure the height of it. We cannot get it straight after all. So we need to apply trigonometry and see. Look at this particular figure now. We have drawn a right-angled triangle with respect to the tree, and we know that an angle of elevation is created here. This is angle of elevation, because you will be looking from here, right? Suppose that this is your eyes. You will be looking from here, and this is the line of vision. Understood? This is angle of elevation. You will get the angle using the instrument, which is used for measuring the angle of elevation. Okay, and thereby you will be getting the angle of elevation in degrees. Suppose that it happens to be 60 degrees, you will find out tan 60 degree. You can measure this distance, and tan 60 degree is nothing but you will be getting the opposite upon adjacent side, and you know the value of it. You will substitute that and get the answer. You will come to know that in the example just in few minutes. So this angle of elevation is helping us to find out the height of the tree without climbing the tree, just by measuring the distance from the tree to where you are standing and by getting the angle of elevation. Another situation can be to find out the height of the hill, which is very important. Again, this height cannot be measured by digging a hole through the center of the heal, which is impossible. So in that case, you will be calculating it by standing away from the hill at a place like this, and by measuring the distance to the hill, and by measuring the angle of elevation again here. This angle will be measured. Understood? These are the ways by which trigonometry is helping us. Think about a situation where lighthouse is, or someone wants to know how far the lighthouse is from the ship. The ship will be in the sea somewhere here. Or just I will apply the again the situation of line of vision, angle of elevation, and thereby you will find out this distance. Here you have to find out the distance from the ship to the lighthouse. So this height of the height is known to you, because lighthouse is made by you. So the height of the lighthouse is known to you. What is not known is this distance. You can calculate again by getting angle of elevation if you are from the ship. Sometime a different situation also may come. Here is a real situation. An observer at a distance of 10 meters from a tree looks at the top of the tree. An observer from a distance of 10 meters from a tree looks at the top of the tree. The angle of elevation is 60 degrees. What is the height of the tree? The same situation is given here. This is the tree. This is observer observing the top of the tree. And this is the distance from the tree. This is the angle of elevation, which is given as 60 degrees. This is the line of vision. What we can do? We have to find out the height of the tree. Understood? In this kind of situation, by drawing this kind of figures, you can solve the situation. So it is given that 1060 60 is given. We can find out the value or the height of the tree by substituting it in our trigonometric ratios. We know that, in the case of tan is always tan of an angle, whichever it may be. Tan theta is equal to opposite side upon adjacent side, right? In this case, we are having tan 60 to be found, and opposite side, if I name this as A, B, C, and we have the 60 degree and 10 meter distance over here, correct? So in this case, tan 60 opposite side is AB upon BC, which is equal to AB, which we have to find out. BC is equal to 10 meter, and tan 60 is a ratio which is equal to root 3 from the table. That means AB upon 10 is equal to, this 10 is in meters, root 3. That means AB is equal to 10 root 3. And root 3 value is given here in the question. So AB is equal to 10 into 1.73, which is equal to 17.3, the unit is meter. We could find out the height of the tree as 17.3 meters. My dear students, how easy it is. Something which is in your mind, which is creating some kind of, how do we get to 60 degree? For that we are having instrument. The instrument is named as inclinometer, or simply clinometer sometime. This instrument is used for measuring the angle of elevation and angle of depression. I will show you that instrument, at least by diagram. I will show you some common inclinometer or inclinoscope, all those things available, where you can measure the slope. Suppose that you equip an inclinoscope on an inclined surface. So naturally it will show up to what degree the surface is inclined, whether it is angle of elevation or depression. Nowadays we are having digital protractor that also can be used for finding out the angle, and we are having the manual type things which will be helpful for us to know what is the inclination. The inclination is nothing but the angle. It can be angle of elevation or depression. But for ships and all, like by sitting or by standing in the ship, you should look through a scope, some kind of a telescope, and as well as you should have a measurement of inclination of that telescope, which you can see here it is coming in the form of digital. There are a lot of such instruments available or made by us in order to measure the angle of inclination, elevation as well as depression. So all this can be learned and understood if you go further about learning about further about engineering session of mathematics. Okay, so you got an idea that the angle of elevation, angle of depression, all can be calculated accurately with the help of instruments, so you will get it. Let us get into another situation from the top of a building. An observer, observer is looking at a scooter parked at a distance away and makes an angle of depression of 30 degree. If the height of the building is 40 meter, two informations are given. Find how far the scooter is. Okay. So here first time we are getting an opportunity to think about depression. Suppose this is a building made by me for you. That's why it's so great. And the man is standing at the top and the scooter is parked over here. Big building and a small scooter. And from here somebody is looking at the top of, from the top of the building to the scooter. So naturally you know that I will draw a horizontal line to make you understand how the concept of angle of depression comes over here. For that I need a straight line. I will draw it from here. Okay, let this be the straight line. Okay, there can be an angle of depression here, right, which is given as 30 degree. Correct. Now angle of depression we got, and here we, the person is looking at the scooter, and the scooter is 40 meter away from the building. The building is having a height of 40 meter. Correct. So we have to draw the height over here. This is the height and it is equal to 40 meter. Good. And the question asked is, what is this distance? This is what is asked. Okay, we got a right angle triangle, our favorite triangle, and we'll mark it as ABC. It is not an issue. ABC or any name you can give. You are asked to find out this particular distance, means distance of the scooter from the building. You know that this is a line drawn horizontal, this is also parallel to it. Naturally this is 30 degree, means this angle is also 30 degree. And this angle, according to us, equal to that, means in the triangle we have an angle 90 degree here, 30 degree here, and we have the measurement of this side 40 meter. Okay, now come, we will substitute tan 30 in this case again, because these are alternate angle. This 30 degree is equal to this angle because they are alternate angle, because these two are parallel. Knowledge of 7th standard. Okay, now tan 30, of they have we know tan 30 is equal to tan 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3. So we will substitute that. Tan in this case is, as far as this 30 is concerned, opposite side is AB upon BC is equal to 1 upon root 3, in which we know AB 40 meter the height, and BC is unknown, and it is equal to 1 upon root 3, and BC is equal to 40 into root 3, which is equal to 40 into 1.73 on multiplying it will become 40, and okay, it is equal to 69.20 meter. 69.20 meter per scooter park kiya hai. See, there is no harm while drawing the diagram. I don't know how far it would be. So the base distance should be, I should have kept the scooter far away. Thoda dur rakhna mangta tha mera scooter. Chalega, no problem. Scooter zyada dur rakhega to building chota ho jayenge. Building bada dikhne do. Okay, not an issue. The point over here is that without measuring the distance at which where it is kept, by just by knowing the angle of elevation, we could calculate to the distance to the scooter. Sunny sochna ke isi measure karna na, we are learning trigonometry where all it can be applied, and this trigonometry when connected with physics, विल बी हेल्पिंग इन फायरिंग फ्रॉम योर राइफल. आप सोचा है कि जो राइफल से फायर कर रहे बड़ा मिसाइल छोड़ने के टाइम एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन कितना इंपॉर्टेंट है. बैड थिंग्स, देर शुड नॉट बी ए सिचुएशन वेयर वी शुड यूज राइफल और मिसाइल, बट वी हैव एक्यूरेसी इन ऑल दीज थिंग्स सो दैट वी हैव डेवलप्ड सच थिंग्स इन आवर डिफेंस सिस्टम ऑल्सो. ओके, दैट इज वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू. एनी वे वी विल मूव अहेड. Here is another situation. The situation is something different here. To find the width of a river, oh, we cannot jump into the river, so we have to use trigonometry. A man observes the top of a tower. He is observing the top of a tower on the opposite bank, making an angle of elevation 61 degree. He is observing from somewhere here. अपोजिट साइड, दिस इज द टावर, सेम टावर, वही टावर लेके मैं इधर आया हूँ रिवर के साइड में. वेन ही मूव्स 50 meters बैक, दैट मीन्स फर्स्ट ही वाज स्टैंडिंग हियर, ही मूव्ड 50 meters बैक, अनदर एंगल ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन मस्ट हैव मेड, बैकवर्ड फ्रॉम द बैंक ही ऑब्जर्व द सेम टॉप ऑफ द टावर. हिज लाइन ऑफ विजन, देखो लाइन ऑफ विजन, मेक्स एन एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑफ 35 degree. Find the height of the tower and width of the river. Tan 61, I told you, when it is other than 30, 60, 45, 0 and 90, you will be getting the measurement directly. Tan 61 is 1.8. Tan 35 degrees equal to 0.7, it is given. Now, my dear student, the situation is that a man stands first here somewhere and observes the top and he gets an angle, then observes somewhere behind and will... He got another angle of elevation, so somewhere like this. He was standing here and observing it from two locations. First at the bank of the river, immediate to the river, then moving 50 meters away from the river bank. So this way we can draw the diagram and apply trigonometry. What is given here is the first observation angle, which is equal to 61 degree, second observation angle, which is equal to 35 degree. Achha. We are asked to find out two things, the height of the tower, of which we are very expert, but we need another data for that. Width of the river, which is something new concept, this width is to be found, which is x. Okay, this way we will be asked to find out how it can be done. And let me show you, suppose that this is A, B is the height of the tower, and first the man was standing here at C, then he moved to D. And here it is 61 degree, I have already marked, here it is 35 degree. These are the information given, and this is 50 meter, this information is also given. I think you can see it, I will change the color if required. This is 50 meter, okay. Now the question is to find out what we say, the height of the tower as well as the width of the river. We will start with what is given. I will go a little shortcut because it is quite lengthy otherwise. You will do it properly. What is given over here, I will write over here in the sky. What is given is tan 61 degree, which is equal to 1.8. If you take tan 61 in our case, degree is equal to opposite side, which is AB upon BC, दोनों हमको मालूम नहीं है, but AB is height, BC X is the width of the river. This all you will write, let X be the width of the river. We have marked it here, Pani mein. This is one equation what we are getting, but we know that 61 कितना होता है, 1.8 it is given here, that we will write here, so that we can write H is equal to 1.8X. चलो. H is equal to 1.8x. एक equation मिल गया. दूसरा situation, tan 635 दिया है, which is equal to 0.7, it is given. And in 35 के केस में opposite side तो AB है, adjacent side is BD, in which AB is H as usual. लास्ट टाइम के जैसा बी डी इज हम 50 ऐड हो गया, x प्लस 50 हो गया, ठीक है. एंड इफ यू राइट द इक्वेशन ऑफ h फ्रॉम दिस, h इज इक्वल टू, h को एक नया इक्वेशन आ रहा है इधर, करेक्ट. ये tan 35 का वैल्यू है इधर, 0.75. So 0.7 into x plus 50, which is equal to, which will be equal to 0.7x plus 35, correct? Right. What is it? We are making an equation for h again. To make it convenient, like removing the point, we can write 10h is equal to 7x plus 350, correct? So we got two equations, 10h is equal to 7s plus 350, h is equal to 1.8x. हम तो master है, simultaneous equation आ गए, तो हम उसके ऊपर खेलेंगे. So from equation 1 and 2, if I substitute this 10h की जगह पे 10 into value of x, which is equal to 1.8x, is equal to 7x plus 350, we will get an equation like this, which is equal to, we can write simply 18x is equal to, well, this became in terms of x now. That's the beauty of equation. Two equations are here, so hum kuch na kuch rasta nikalenge. 7x plus 350 subtract karega to 11x is equal to, sorry, 350 here. 11x is equal to 350. Are wah, x is equal to 350 upon 11. Oh, not easily divisible. Let me see by, without wasting time artificially. Okay, it happens to be 31.82. Good. 31.82. That is what is x. So we'll write 31.82 as the width of the river, and as it is given 50 meter here, we are having meter here, we are having meter here. Who? हम पानी में ना उतर के river का width तो find out किया. अभी आगे मैं नहीं बोलूँगा क्योंकि आपको ये substitute करना है ना. X मिल गया तो आपको h में substitute करना है. H किधर भी substitute करो, इधर substitute करो. X मिल गया width of the river and h is equal to 1.8 into x. That is 1.8 into 31.8, which on calculation you will get 57.28 meter. The 82 meter, okay. So you got it. You got the width of the river and height of the tower without climbing on the without climbing on the tower, or nor by jumping into the river. By standing on the other side of the river, you could find out. और क्या चाहिए आपको? हाँ, क्या चाहिए पूछे तो वो आपका angle of elevation measure करने वाले instrument चाहिए. तो आपको समझ में आया, अगर एक plane ऊपर से चल रहे हो, instrument है तो अभी आप Because the textbook won't be giving you such explanation what way you have to think. Because sometimes the textbook, for example, I am taking another from the textbook now, which will be, see, here is a question from the textbook. Roshni saw an angle on the, saw an eagle, not angle, triangle pada ke angle hi ho gaya. Roshni saw an eagle on the top of a tree at an angle of elevation of 61 degree, right? Eagle ko dekh rahe. Kaun dekh rahe? Roshni dekh rahe. Okay. Well, she was standing on the door of her house. She went onto the terrace of the house so that she could see it clearly. The terrace was at a height of 4 meter. Dekho, either 4 meter height bana diya. So, ye aapko draw karna hai. Aapko to building na draw karna hai, na eagle ko draw karna hai. So, you should know to draw the diagram. That's another task now. Okay. While observing the eagle from there, from the terrace. Now, she is at terrace. the angle of elevation of 52 degree was observed. At what height the from the ground, either say, from here, the ground of the eagle is, you can have the help of 61 degrees equal to 1.8, 52 degrees equal to 1.28, tan 29 degrees equal to 0.55, tan 38 degrees equal to 0.78. That means you are given clue for everything, and another important clue is you are using tan only. So something is coming into your mind that you can solve it, but this diagram you will not get in the exam. That you have to create yourself. For that you need to draw your own house and your own observation angle, then thereafter convert that into a proper trigonometrical diagram. That's why I was showing you pictures related. Even this I can show you in the form of pictures for the last time, because rest of the sums you will imagine how the diagram would be. And see, my dear students, I can simply help you by giving you the answer, by showing the answer over here and doing the sum on the screen, but it will not make you strong, I'm sure. So take time, you are having exam in March, you can practice January, February, 2 months complete practice, and now is the time to understand slowly, clearly, perfectly, then you will practice, then you will speed up. Okay, if I draw that particular thing which is given in the question that in this diagram, Roshni ka ghar hai samajh lo, and she was standing in front of her house, there is a tree and some eagle is sitting, she was standing somewhere here on the ground. जो डायग्राम मुझे मिला, जो हाउस घर मुझे मिला, वही डालेगा ना मैं. ओके, शी इज ऑब्जर्विंग एंड इट इज सेड दैट देयर इज एन एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन 61 डिग्री टू इट, एंड शी क्लाइम्ड अप टू 4 मीटर अप स्टेयर्स और टेरेस, देन अगेन शी ऑब्जर्व अगेन एन एंगल ऑफ व्हाट वी से 52 डिग्री. व्हाट दिस एंगल्स आर, दिस एंगल्स आर विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द ग्राउंड, like ground line or horizontal line drawn here. This is what is the first case where you will be having 61 degree as your observation angle, and if you are thinking about the next case, another line can be drawn, and this is equal to 52 degree as far as Roshni is concerned. And we know that there will be another horizontal line here which I have to draw, without which I cannot complete this. So I will be drawing a horizontal line here also. Okay, if I draw an horizontal line over here, I know that is my knowledge from 9th standard and class below that. If it is 61 here, I can write 29 here, because 69 plus 29 is 90, the right angle is here, that angle is fixed, correct? Understood? If it is 52 here, if it is 52 here, here it is 90 degree, correct? Here it is 90 degree again. If it is 90 degree here, if it is 52 degree here, this whole, this will be making 38 degree. There are more ways to find out this, but one way I am telling you. So you have marked all these angles if you want. Understood? And it is given that she climbed 4 meter up, so this also 4 meter. And there is a rise of height over here. हमको उसके बारे में आइडिया नहीं है. We can put it as y over here. Okay, and we can write, mark ABC always. Suppose that in this case we will mark P is where she was standing. She climbed up to Q and observed the eagle over here, right over there. And this is the ground level parallel to P, and this is the mid level after 4 meter height. 4 meter height. Okay, all this. So that means this diagram, if you succeed in drawing, then the rest of the things automatically follows. वो तो अभी आपको मालूम है. That you know now how the things are solved in different situations. So my dear student, diagram drawing the diagram is very important. That you should do very slowly, correctly, intelligently. Okay. Meanwhile, I have no question over here. Let me copy the important aspect of question, like what is given in the question over here. It is given in the question tan 61. I am copying from your textbook. Tan 61 is equal to 1.8 is given. Tan 52 degrees is equal to 1.28 is given. Good. And tan 29 डिग्री, देखो 29 दिया है इसलिए हम 29 का काम आएगा इधर 0.55 एंड ऑल्सो 10:38 इज ऑल्सो गिवन विच इज रिटन ओवर हियर विच इज इक्वल टू 0.78. सो मीन्स आई थिंक ऑल सच ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस आर गिवन. नाउ व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज ओनली ए सिंपल कॉमन सेंस ओवर हियर. We are having this distance is not given, which is can be named as x. We don't know how much it is. It may come in use, I don't know. And we can see that there are two right-angled triangles in front of us. One is like RSP triangle, RSP is there. Another is RTQ, where we'll be comparing. And these two angles, 29 degree and 38 degree, belongs to these two. We know that how we get 29 and 38, you will write it when you are writing the answer. You will write that 90 degree minus 61 degree. This is what is 29, and 90 degree minus 52 degree is 38 degree. All these things you will write. And let me make use of the given situation where you are having 10, 61, 52, 29, 38 degree, and your question is about to find out the height y plus 4 meters. So we need to find out y. So we will always try to get such an equation where y comes as a term. So the best thing is finding out tan only, and in that case we can just try to find out tan 29 degree, which is equal to 55 degree, which is equal to tan 29 is here. Opposite is x, okay. Opposite is x, adjacent side is y plus 4. In which, if you are considering the triangle PRS, for example, triangle PRS, okay. So tan 29 degree is equal to x upon y plus 4 meter, and it is equal to 55 degree. That means x is equal to 0.55 into y plus 4, right? Rene do, acha equation x ka. Let this be the equation 1 for us. X ka ek equation mil gaya. Can we make one more equation for x? The last sum ke jaisa kar sakte hain. Let us try tan 38 degree, which is equal to 0.78. 38 degree bole to this is the 38 degree, and this is opposite side, and this is what is the adjacent side. Okay, so we will consider the triangle QR and T. Chalo. Then in triangle QRT we will try for tan 38. Dekho, Q, R and T. Tabhi to apna 38 ki baat ho jayega. Now in this also opposite is X again. Opposite upon tan 38 degree, that which is equal to 0.78. Opposite side is X upon adjacent side, which is equal to y. Okay, we can get an equation in terms of x is equal to 0.78 y. So we got two equations for x. Again, our algebraic idea comes into practice here. We are having two equations. Let me mark this as equation 1, and this as, there are many ways to solve this particular situation. We got these two. 0.78 y is equal to x, as at the same time 0.55 into y plus 4. This both are, let us equate both. That means 0.55 y plus 4 is equal to 0.78 y. So we are getting y, we need y only. Y ke upar se humko ek answer create ho sakta hai isme. We know that how do we do that? We know that this is equal to 0.55 y plus this is equal to 220, right? If you are multiplying 55 with 4, it will be 220. Here it is 2.20, which is equal to 0.78y. Now, let us multiply the whole equation with 10. So, all these, not 10, we will multiply it with 100, so that all these decimal point will be escaped, will be removed. So, it becomes 78y is equal to 55y plus 220. I am going shortcut to save time. 78 minus 55 is equal to 23y is equal to 220. Oh, 231 among tada. Easy hota tha. Y is equal to 220 upon 23. So, humko jo chahiye mil rahe, isliye main khush hu. So, when we divide this, we need little time to divide this. If it was 25 also it was easy. Let me do it separately to save time. It happens to be 9.565. Okay. This is what is Y. Y मिल गया तो अपना प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो गया. 9.565 क्वेश्चन में दिया था आपको, ये नियरेस्ट डेसिमल में एडजस्ट करना. 9.5 के बाद 6 होने की वजह से यू आर आस्क्ड टू एडजस्ट इट फॉर नेक्स्ट 10. दैट मीन्स इट विल अप्रॉक्सीमेटली, दिस इज एक्यूरेट, दैट मीन्स अप्रॉक्सीमेटली इट इज 10 ओनली. सो वी गॉट इट, Y इज इक्वल टू 10. इफ इट इज इक्वल टू 10, यू कैन कैलकुलेट द अदर वन ऑल्सो, वट इज कॉल्ड. We have the height of the this one. Y is equal to 10. Y plus 4 is equal to 10 plus 4. That means 14 meter is the height of the tree from the ground. Roshni could get it. My dear students, we could solve a very peculiar sum where Roshni stood on the ground floor, फिर उसके बाद ऊपर क्लाइम करके गया, अच्छा सीढ़ी है, और ऊपर जाके वापस ऑब्जर्व किया, ऑब्जर्व करके एंगल दिया हमको, और उन्होंने एक फ्लोर ऊपर चढ़ने से कितना ऊपर मीटर ऊपर गया वो भी बताया. वेरी गुड, थैंक यू Roshni, एंड वी कुड सॉल्व इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ trigonometry. गुड, लेट अस थिंक अबाउट वन मोर सम, दैट वी विल क्लोज. Here is a tree standing in front of you, very good tree. And somebody have made it so perfect in such a way that now you are asked to find out the height of this tree, because the tree which we saw had fallen down like this. Gir gaya. So kya karenge? You are asked to find out the height of the tree. There is a tree. And again, it will be given the angle of angle created when it is fallen. I'm not giving you the full clue of this particular sum, because even if I do the last sum also, it is not good for you. Last sum, example sum only. Exercise you have to do as usual. You have to make strong. But January, February will be spent on doing the sums and the exercise. जो आपने time पे काम नहीं किया उनके लिए, जो काम किया उनके लिए. प्रैक्टिस के ऊपर प्रैक्टिस का टाइम है. जो कुछ भी काम नहीं किया जनवरी फरवरी में बैठ के एक्सरसाइज करेंगे. इट्स नेचुरल ना, जो पहले एक्सरसाइज नहीं किया अभी करेंगे. ओके, ए ट्री वॉज ब्रोकन ड्यू टू स्टॉर्म एंड इट्स ब्रोकन पार्ट वॉज सो इंक्लाइंड दैट इट्स टॉप टच्ड द ग्राउंड मेकिंग एन एंगल 30 degrees विद द ग्राउंड. द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द फुट ऑफ द ट्री एंड द point where the top touched the ground was 10 meter. What was the height of the tree? Was पूछ रहा हूँ, tree का height कितना था पूछ रहे. वो गिर गया ना, तो naturally. So here the situation is in such a that we are comparatively easier one. We are having a tree. Let us mark the tree as AB. ऐसा एक tree खड़ा था, मालूम है ना, ऐसा था tree. तो फिर वो गिर गया. गिर गया तो ऐसा हो गया. बट इट इज गिवन दैट इट क्रिएटेड एन एंगल हियर 30 degrees. अंडरस्टूड? एन एंगल ऑफ 30 degrees वॉज क्रिएटेड इन सच ए वे दैट इट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट ग्राउंड मेक एन एंगल 30 degrees विथ ग्राउंड. तो इधर है एंगल, एक 30 degrees का एंगल बना दिया. ओके, द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द फुट टू द ट्री the distance from the foot of the tree and the point where the tree top touched is 10 meter. ये भी दिया है, तो comparatively an easy one. I don't want to do it. What is the height of the tree? But the peculiarity is that if you consider this point as C where it is broken and D as a point where it is touched, so we are having an angle 30 degree here and BD is equal to 10 meter. We are asked to find out the height of the tree. Let us consider BC, we will get easily X meter. But one thing, if you can get BC and this, you have to calculate this side, which is hypotenuse, which we don't know now. We will calculate that and we will equate it with this, because these two are equal. Tip of the tree to idhar tak da, wahi to idhar aake gir gaya. So this distance will be equal to this distance. So that you should keep in mind. So let us go mathematically. I will do this mathematically. What I will write? I will first write that angle CDB is equal to 30 degree, which is given. This way you have to start with. BD is given as 10 meter. Aur kya diya hai? BC diya nahi hai. We can say X meter. And we can also say that ye jo distance hai na, CA is equal to CD. We can mark it as Y meter. Ye hamara information hai. Now, tan 30 we know. Tan 30 degree means opposite side upon adjacent side, which will be equal to X upon 10 in this case. Correct? And tan 30 value we know, which is equal to 1 upon root 3. So we got an equation for X. Correct? X is equal to, otherwise for your knowledge, X root 3 is equal to 10 and X is equal to 10 upon root 3. Correct? That much we reached. We got an equation for X. So let us celebrate marking it as 1. Okay. We got an equation. X is equal to 10 upon root 3. If X is equal to 10 upon root 3, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. X mil gaya. This is equal to 10 upon root 3. Here we are having 10 meter. So what is Y we are asked to find out? If we got Y, we will double it and get the answer. Understood? We'll add with that. And we'll add with X and we'll get the answer. So to find out Y, we have to apply Pythagoras theorem. It kabhi bhi kaam mein aata hai. According to that, here Y square, it would be Y square, right? Y square will be equal to 10 upon root 3 whole square plus, that is this, 10 square, which will be equal to 100 upon 3 plus 100. Which will be equal to, that is, we are calculating Y square, which will be equal to 100 plus 300 upon 3, which is equal to 400 upon 3. Y is equal to root of 400 upon 3, that is 200 upon, sorry, not 220 upon root 3. So we got 20 upon root 3 as Y. Chalo. Y bhi mil gaya. Abhi humko pucha kya hai, ye sochna padega. We are asked to find out the height of the tree. So we have X here 10 root 3, Y as 20 root 3. This is also 20 root 3 then. 20 upon root 3. So me razor nahi, isliye main cut kar raha hu. Aap erase karenge. Ab mistake hi nahi karenge. So now Y you got, X you got. So X plus Y is equal to 10 root upon root 3 plus 20 upon root 3, which is the height of the tree. Correct? Height of the tree. So ye kitna hoga? 10 upon root 3 and 20 upon root 3, which is equal to 30 upon root 3. Correct? X plus Y is equal to 30 upon root 3. This way you can write the answer. X plus y is equal to 30 upon root 3. Understood, my dear students? So we got the height of the tree as 30 upon root 3. That is what is asked. So here comes the end of explanation of examples. Examples are explained because they are examples for solving the sums given in the textbook. Only 6 sums are given. If I explain those 6 sums, I am 101% sure. It's 8% in EMS. 101% sure that you will become weak. I don't want my students to be weak. Thereafter, you will be going for problem set 6, where you are applying all the knowledge of trigonometry learned from 9th standard till now in different situations, and will enjoy. And by the end of those 10 questions of problem set 6, I am quite sure that you will be an expert, provided ek condition hai. Aap guide mein bhi nahi dekhenge, internet mein bhi nahi dhoondenge, khud baith ke exercise karenge. खुद बैठ के इतना एक्सरसाइज करेंगे कि आप इतना स्ट्रांग आएंगे, कोई भी क्वेश्चन, कोई भी सामने नहीं, कोई भी क्वेश्चन सामने आने दो, यू विल फेस इट बिकॉज यू हैव डन द एक्सरसाइज योरसेल्फ, सो यू आर स्ट्रांग. थैंक यू. नाउ क्लिक ऑन द सब्सक्रिप्शन बटन बिलो to subscribe the channel, then the bell button to get the notifications of the new videos. Thank you.